got some mixed number subtraction here for you. Now, it looks an awful lot like mixed number addition. And we know how to handle mixed number addition. We split the mixed numbers into integer parts and fractional parts. Now, when I find a strategy that works, I like to keep using it. So that's what we're going to start with here. We're going to take each of these mixed numbers and split them into an integer part and a fractional part. So we get 12 plus 5 eighths, and the 3 and a quarter becomes 3 plus 1 quarter. Now notice these parentheses here, they're very important. What we're doing when we subtract 3 and a quarter is we're subtracting the 3 and we're subtracting the quarter. So when we distribute this out, we get minus 3 and minus a quarter. And again, that's because we're subtracting 3 and a quarter, we're subtracting 3 and we're subtracting a quarter. There's not a plus, there's a minus. Very important. Now once we have everything as integer parts and fractional parts, we can handle the integers and the fractions separately. We can split this up as 12 minus 3, and then 5 eighths minus a quarter. 12 minus 3, that's easy, that's just 9. 5 eighths minus a quarter, we'll get a common denominator. Common denominator is 8. 1 quarter is 2 eighths. And so we get 9 and 5 eighths minus 2 eighths, that gives us 3 eighths. And notice that the original problem is in terms of mixed numbers. So we write our answer as a mixed number. And we're on to the next problem. And we know how to handle this now. We just break our mixed numbers into integer parts and fractional parts. And once again, we remember these parentheses here because we're subtracting the 3 and we're subtracting the half. So we distribute that out. We get minus 3 and minus a half. Once again, we deal with the integers and the fractions separately. 7 minus 3 is 4. 1 sixth minus 1 half. Get a common denominator. 1 half is 3 sixths. So we get 4. 1 sixth minus 3 sixths. 1 minus 3 is 2. So this is 4 minus 2 sixths. Of course, we can simplify that 2 sixths. That's just 1 third. So we get 4 minus a third, which is what? Well, you know what I like to do when I'm puzzled with fractions is I break out the number line. Fractions are numbers, so they live on the number line. So I'm going to think about where they live on the number line. 4 minus a third, we're subtracting. We're starting at 4 and we're subtracting, so we're going to go this way. We're going to go to the left. So we're going to break the number line between 3 and 4 into thirds. We're going to go left by a third from 4, and we see that we end up at 3 and 2 thirds. And once again, problem is written as mixed numbers, so our answer is written as a mixed number as well. Let's try one more, make sure we have this down. Hey, wait a second. It's not a subtraction problem, that's an addition problem. We got a negative number plus something. We do have that negative sitting out there, so it's kind of like a subtraction problem. Well, let's just start off with the strategy that's been working all along. We'll take our mixed number and write it as an integer plus a fractional part. And once again, notice how important these parentheses are. We're taking a negation here of the 18 and the 2 thirds. So you have the negative of 18 plus 2 thirds. And of course, we'll split up the 5 and 3 quarters into 5 and 3 quarters. And we're going to distribute this out. We'll get minus 18 minus 2 thirds. Again, that negative out there applies to the 18 and to the 2 thirds. Plus 5 plus 3 quarters. And of course, we'll handle the integer parts and the fractional parts separately. Minus 18 plus 5, that's minus 13. And to take care of our fractions, we get a common denominator. Common denominator, we have 3 and 4, so we'll get use 12 as the common denominator. We multiply the top and bottom of this by 4. We get 8 twelfths. Multiply the top and bottom of this by 3. That gives us 9 twelfths. So we have negative 13 minus 8 twelfths plus 9 twelfths. That just leaves us 1 twelfth. Now, what does that equal? What's minus 13? Negative 13 plus a 12th. Is that negative 13 and a 12th? I'm puzzled again. I'm going to break out my number line. I think about the number line. I usually can't go wrong. So I'm going to start at negative 13 and add. So I'm going to go to the right on the number line. So I'm going to start at negative 13 and I'm going to add a 12. I'm going to go to the right. So I'm going to go towards negative 12. So the answer can't be negative 13 and a 12. Negative 13 and a 12 is out here. It'll be out here somewhere. Negative 13 and a 12 is when I go from negative 13 and I take a step to the left. So what's this number? Well, to get to this number, I can go to the right by 1/12 from negative 13, or I can start at negative 12 and go this way. Negative 12, I go one step, that's negative 12 and 1/12, and 2/12, 3/12, 4/12, and so on. It's going to take me 11/12 to get all the way out here, because there are 12/12 total. I'm only one away from negative 13. So this point out here is going to be negative 12, and I'm going to have to take 11 steps to get out there, and 11/12. And once again, you see our key to solving these problems. I take the mixed number, I split it into an integer part and a fractional part. And if I ever get a little puzzled, I don't just write down, I don't just guess an answer. I think about the number line, and it'll get me to my answer. Because, well, I use the number line because fractions are numbers. ¶¶